evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Loveland. I'm the high school principal here, and wanted to welcome everyone to our first concert of the year. Our first concert of the year. As with any of our programs and also many activities at school, please make sure your cell phones are turned off or down so that it doesn't interrupt the performances. This evening, we're doing songs of hope, love, forgiveness, and grace. With all the turmoil in the world, return to having hope, love, forgiveness, with a little bit of grace is an important time right now for all of us. And so, this evening, I'd like us to just take a moment before the concert begins, a moment of prayer or reflection of the many things and blessings in our lives, but also with the idea of hope for our community and for our future. So please take a moment, again, of prayer or reflection. Thank you. This evening you're going to enjoy a fantastic concert, and one of the quotes I wanted to leave and kind of start the concert off with is from Maya Angelou. She says, God puts rainbows in the clouds so that each of us, in the dreariest and most dreaded moments, can see the possibilities of hope. Tonight we have a fantastic concert set up for you. Your students have been working really hard, and we hope you have a great enjoy the concert, and thank you for all your continued support. Thank you.
everybody. Thank you for coming to our band concert tonight. The march we just played, Colonel Bogey, is named after Mr. Gavlik's golf shot, the Bogey. No, but really. Colonel Bogey was composed by Kenneth Alford in 1914, roughly around the same time Mr. Gavlik was born. No, really. Enough about Mr. Gavlik's head. Oh, I mean age. Since service personnel, we're not encouraged to have professional lives outside the army. At least somebody likes my jokes. British Army Bandmaster F.J. Ricketts published Colonel Bogey and his other compositions under the pseudonym Kenneth Alford.
According to stories, the tune was inspired by a military man and golfer who would whistle the descending notes instead of yelling four when playing. So instead of yelling, hey, watch out, he would whistle. It was famously used in the 1957 film, The Bridge on the River Kwai. We hope that you enjoyed whistling along with us.
James and Connie will now introduce our next piece.
Amazing Grace is a Christian hymn published in 1779 by English poet and former slave trader John Newton. Some believe that the melody of this song actually stemmed from the cries of the slaves on the ships which Newton sailed. Its melody uses the same scale as many West African folk songs.
In relation to Newton's former sea life, we believe the dynamics in our version resemble waves, small crescendos and decrescendos. The first verse holds a strong triumphant tone, led by a brass section. The second verse, in contrast to the song, is a softer, warmer tone, led by a woodwind section. The third verse opens with a strong, heartwarming arrival, resembling the weeping and repentance Newton felt as he realized the true wretchedness of the slave trade.
It is a hymn considered by many to be a spiritual. Some estimate that Amazing Grace is performed 10 million times annually. We haven't quite rehearsed it that many times, but it's close enough. Its popularity may be due to the beautiful melody, or maybe due to the longing that so many experience for grace and forgiveness in their lives.
The lyrics are written about Newton coming to faith in Christ as he turned away from the slave trade. He continually described the amazing gift of forgiveness he experienced, knowing that he didn't deserve it. We will show the lyrics of the verse of Amazing Grace on the screen while we play. We hope that you can relate to the incredible story this piece tells, can connect it to your life, and can connect it to current events in the city. Thank you.
Thank you.
do you think when you hear the word hope? Our next piece, A Song of Hope, was originally written in memory of the Sandy Hook Elementary School victims. It was written not only for them, but for all victims of senseless violence. If you followed the news in Hong Kong recently, it is clear that there are some who feel hopeless. The theme of tonight's concert is songs of hope, love, grace, and forgiveness. Through this song, we encourage you to have hope when you face adversity. The piece starts soft and low, conveying the sadness and devastation left after unnecessary violence. Then it alternates between sounds of sorrow and hope, much like the emotional roller coaster people feel who experience loss. During this difficult time, where it may be hard to express in words exactly what we are feeling about the political situation and protests in our city, we hope that this piece will help each and every one of you to connect more with emotions you're feeling, help us to express ourselves, and point towards hope for a better future.
Thanks so much. The student said it really well. So in times of joy, in times of sadness, anything else that you might be feeling, music can help to express deeply felt intricacies of emotions in ways that words alone can't. As Amazing Grace describes, when you're searching for hope, I encourage you to look towards Christ for grace, hope, love, and forgiveness. And yeah, there are many in our city right now that are longing for justice and freedom, many that are longing for peace and safety. So know that justice and freedom, peace, safety, grace, love, hope, forgiveness, they're all coming through the Redeemer. We pray that it would come quickly. It's incredible how the words by John Newton nearly 250 years ago speak directly to the challenges that we face today. So through many dangers, toils, and snares, I've already come. 'Twas grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me. His word my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. What an incredible feeling to be given a free gift that you know you don't deserve. That's what God's grace is. We really are blessed. We ask for your grace tonight also if you hear any musical imperfections in our performance. And we encourage you to come back for our Christmas concert on December 7th. And hopefully you'll hear us sounding even better by that point. I also want to apologize for a slightly later start time for our concert than usual on a weeknight. So we actually moved the concert start time back a little bit to allow our many athletes who are in band to play in some volleyball games today. So thank you also for your grace with that. And I also really just want to say a thank you, parents, to you especially for encouraging your children to practice and encouraging them to make music an important part of their lives. So music really allows us to experience the joy of creating something beautiful together with others. So by themselves, each one of your children is really amazing. When you put them together, the sum is much greater than the individual parts. And so it really is an amazing thing to be able to bring them all together, and thank you for supporting your children, encouraging them to do that. So recently we've seen a lot of pictures and videos of people tearing things apart in our city. And what an amazing thing that every day in our school, your children, they come together with people from different countries, different backgrounds, to build each other up and to create something beautiful together. So thank you, parents, for your encouragement and support. Thanks for coming tonight. We're really happy that you're here.
Spring musical?
No, I'm just excited for Halloween coming up. Candy, costumes, and spooky sounds. It's the only time of year when it's socially acceptable to scare your friends in the hallway.
But what does Halloween have to do with the theme of our band concert?
I hope for candy.
Dark Ride, the last piece for symphonic band, depicts an action-packed ride through the spooky moonlit night as you're chased by an ominous creature. Due to the drastic changes in tempo and dynamics, it evokes strong feelings of suspense and excitement.
On a personal note, during baseball practice, many teammates would hum the tune of this song to support the team. We play this song on repeat, and it truly brings more excitement and energy to the baseball team.
We hope to portray the same excitement and give you the same thrill that we experienced while playing the piece.
Happy early Halloween.
Tell me about it, Adrian.
The piece you just heard is called Fire Dance by David Sheffer. It's the perfect piece for some of our younger students as they come up to the wind ensemble.
Cool. Our next piece is going to take you on an emotional journey. It's called Just a Closer Walk with Thee. It starts with a slow and soulful section before launching into a fast-paced and joyful one.
The Dixieland jazz piece has its origins in New Orleans, where it was commonly performed in African-American funerals. Back then, they weren't allowed to bury their dead within city limits. In fact, many of them were abused, beaten, and attacked. Large processions would walk out of the city to song, carrying the casket to be buried in the suburbs.
The slow section represents the tragedy and grief of losing a loved one. Be sure to listen for the wailing sounds in the clarinet, trumpet, and trombone that represent the grieving wails of the mourners themselves.
The fast section then comes in to celebrate the spirit of the loved one passing into a better afterlife. They don't have to deal with the hardships that they had to deal with. This section will feature many brass soloists who capture the joyful atmosphere.
As students preparing for this piece, we really had to capture the raw emotion to really do it justice. It's actually very relatable to us seniors. We are celebrating the upcoming university years and the friendships we'll make along the way.
Yes, but we're also mourning the loss of our sleep and our questionable GPAs. Please, Mr. Gavlik, please give me an A.
That hit a little too close to home. I hope you enjoy.
by reading you a poem, My Western Home. You may recognize the poem as a lyric to the song Home on the Range. My Western Home. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam and the deer and the antelope play, where never is heard a discouraging word and the sky is not clouded all day.
This sentiment of home and hope portrayed in this poem leads into our next piece.
Our next piece, And the Antelope Play, is a tone poem that shows the transformation over time of Antelope Valley as the Antelope and Native American tribes lose their home to changes. The story is shown through 8 sections.
The story starts at the spirit world. We then move into the first section, First There Is Wind. Starts the piece with the sound of a warm desert wind, a single tumbleweed, and the sound of a Native American flute.
Okay. The next section, Morning Light, signals rays of sun breaking through the sky.
This is followed by Behold the Valley, where the vastness of the valley is shown through a beautiful chorale.
Once we're envisioning this valley, we transition into the section And the Antelope Play, where the indigenous pronghorn antelope is portrayed through their playful percussion entrances and trumpet melody.
However, this happy scene is soon disturbed by the next section, The Plight of the Valley. This signals the western expansion of the railroad, represented by the snare drum and 2 trumpet fanfares. The Americans arriving and the mariachi band that disrupts the valley and begins the demise of the antelope and the various Native American tribes.
But at the end of all this disruption, we see a glimmer of hope as we enter the section The Spirit Remains. The same Native American flute theme we heard in the beginning is reprised in Solo Piccolo.
Though the valley is changed forever, we enter the section And the Antelope, showing how the spirit of the antelope and the tribe still remains.
We finally transition to a more climactical reprise of the beautiful Valley Chorale in the last section, Valley Home. This depicts a lasting memory of the valley that lingers despite the loss of the home they once had. The piece ends with a fragment of the song, Oh Give Me a Home. And concludes with a solo flute and triangle as they play a fragment that represents home. As you listen to this piece, we invite you to think about your own homes. We hope you enjoy.
British boy band we were talking about yesterday?
Yeah, of course, our favorite band, One Direction. Haven't you seen Harry Styles' swoon-worthy hair? His locks are just so long and luscious, unlike someone else.
While I agree with you, I actually meant the other boy band, the one that shares its name with an insect and a car.
Huh? Wait, what?
Look, Anna, I know it's been a hard day's night, staying up and writing college apps. Sometimes you just want to hold someone's hand, but you should know this.
Ugh, yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away, and now I have to add not knowing this band to the list. Maggie, I really don't know. Just let it be.
Fine, I'll give you a small hint. It starts with a B and ends with an Eagles.
Oh, right, the Beatles.
Okay, now that Anna's finally got it, we'll be performing the Symphonic Beatles, a medley of the Beatles' top hits.
We'll also be featuring solos from Adrian Lee, Maggie Liu, and Bowen Ju. We hope you enjoy. Be ready to watch Mr. Gavlik's cue and sing along with us at the very end. Carolyn's going to give us a brief demonstration.
Matthias, where are you? Hey, just remember, God made some heads bald, the rest he covered with hair, the beautiful heads he left without hair. So remember that.
Thank you.
So we wanted to say a few thank yous to everyone. So thank you very much to
David Loveland,
Brent Perico,
Lauren Fine,
and Sue Harvey for their
administrative support.
To Heatherly Stevens,
Danny Wong,
Theater Tech students,
for their technical support.
To Anthony Hoy,
Sue Kim Bai,
KK Tam,
and the facilities and maintenance team
for setup.
Violet Chu
for the poster design,
and Amanda Chung
for the concert slideshow.
SDLT students
for the concert video recording.
Anna Chen,
for helping organize the tech team and the recording of the concert.
Wind Ensemble
and Symphonic Band
leadership teams
for helping organize the recent retreats and this concert.
Parents, for your continued support
of the performing arts at HKIS.
Wait a second. I think we're forgetting a few people. I think we forgot some of the most important people, our wives, for putting up with us.
Yeah, say thank you. Thank you. And of course, most importantly, let's thank all of our students for their wonderful performance.
Thank you to the students from the bottom of our hearts. We just enjoy making music with you every day. We get to listen to them day after day and just enjoy the journey of making music together. And it just blesses our hearts, and it's something we love to do. So thank you, students, for making our days beautiful. Hope you have a great evening. Thank you.
See you at our next concert. Bye.